Now, many people these days, or many women these days, are doing it all. They're raising kids, working, caring for elderly parents, running a household. The list goes on and on. Now, unfortunately, because of this, because they're taking care of everyone else, some are not taking care of themselves. So today we're talking about women's health with Amanda O'Neill, a registered dietitian with the Castle Medical Center. Hello, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
So Amanda, let's jump right in. What are some things that a woman needs to be thinking about and doing throughout her lifetime to stay healthy in a proactive way?
Well, I think first off, women need to be thinking establishing a physician first off, whether it be in adolescent years or menopausal years, whether it be a pediatrician who is doing regular screenings, regular vaccinations, whether you're getting into your primary care physicians or seeing an internist later in life. I think that the annual exams, the well woman exams, is probably the first thing that I think women need to be paying attention to, is just having an established physician, because so many women, they just wait and something pops up and then they don't have a physician to take care of them. So
you bring up such a good point, and I'm guilty of this too, Amanda. You know, we take our kids for annual exams, right?
Yes.
We never skip those, but it had been 5 years. I went without seeing a physician for 5 years. It's not good. So this year I got everything done. But it's true. I think, you know, women put their own health on the back burner.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
So let's break it down one by one. So tell me about like adolescent years. What are some things that we should do during that phase?
Well, I wish somebody would have told me what to do in an adolescent from, I'll give you three phases through either nutrition or exercise or lifestyle changes that should be thought about at all stages of your life. But okay. I think during adolescent years, probably from a nutrition standpoint, is the calcium and vitamin D, because that's really laying the foundation for preventing bone disease later in life. I don't know if you saw the American Academy of Pediatrics this past year, I believe they said that our kids are not getting enough sleep. So they're actually talking about changing the time of when school starts. So really, sleep 8.5 to 9.5 hours per day, obviously in those years. And
you know why they get so much homework.
Right?
So the kids are going to sleep so late because they bring home so much homework.
That's true. And obviously not smoking, not at that time, not at any time throughout your life, and even starting sunscreen at that time.
Yes.
You know, making sure that you're taking care of yourself that way in adolescent years. I think more importantly in reproductive years, I always tell my clients to make sure that they're taking, if they're planning on having a child, taking a multivitamin with some extra folic acid would be a place to start. I think women, we're always concerned about our weight, and then we do things the wrong way. Mm-hmm. So focus on whole foods throughout your life, more of a plant-based eating style, and exercise. I mean, 150 minutes to 300 minutes of exercise is the recommendation. So I tell a lot of my clients, so they're like, yeah, I got my 30 minutes in a day. Well, what do you do the rest of the day? Mm. It's about being active all day. And so a woman, she's busy, she's focused on career, possibly children. So I think paying attention to getting that time, and mental health. Mental health is so important. Stress management, breathing techniques, whatever it is during that time to prevent hopefully chronic disease in the future.
I saw something recently on social media. It was like, it was really cute, saying, you know, one lunch date with their girlfriends is better than,
absolutely,
is more helpful than paying for a psychiatrist or a therapist. You know?
Absolutely. I don't know if you're familiar with the blue zones that have recently come out, but it's something everybody should kind of look into. But I think we should all be living in a cul-de-sac with our friends.
Right? That would really be good for our health.
Yes.
I believe.
And then in menopausal years, I think from the exercise standpoint is our strength training. Mm-hmm. I think that more in any aspect is really focused on strength training and women, prevention of chronic disease. Your calorie requirements actually go down as you age, but you still need that good protein throughout your life. So focusing on a good protein source every few hours and getting that strength training, and obviously going for your well woman exams.
Yes. Yeah. So how can people get in touch with you? You guys have a wellness center.
Yes, we have a wellness center connected to Castle Medical Center in the Weinberg building. We have everything there. We have tobacco treatment counseling. We do fitness classes. We also have a personal trainer for hire. We do vegan cooking classes. I run the diabetes program, so I'm also a diabetes educator. and I do all of the nutrition education there. So definitely stop by the Wellness Center for any type, for all stages, adolescence through menopausal years. All women are welcome at our Wellness Center.
All right, Amanda, thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
We're going to have all of that information on our website. That's wonderful that you guys have all those to
resources,
offer.
Yes, absolutely.